Today, the Treasury Department reported that more than half of the homeowners enrolled in the HAMP program have been disqualified. Also today, there were new developments in the ongoing foreclosure mess. For an update on that part of the story, we're joined now by Binyamin Appelbaum of the New York Times. Welcome back.
Thank you.
We saw in our news summary Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke weighing in today. Tell us, what specifically is he looking at?
What he has said is that the Federal Reserve is reviewing the machinery of foreclosure. They're looking at the way that banks process foreclosures to ascertain how banks make sure that they're foreclosing on the right people and that they have the right to take those homes.
And whether people were kicked out of their homes who shouldn't have been.
Well, that's what they're hoping not to find.
They're hoping not to find. But we still don't really know the extent of that.
Right? We don't. We know that there have been isolated instances in which people lost homes and perhaps shouldn't have, but we have no idea how common it was.
Now, how much authority does the Fed have? What could it do if it finds problems?
Well, the Fed has a great deal of authority over banks. They can both force banks to make reforms to their process to make sure that it is working the way that it is supposed to. And potentially they can take punitive action against banks that are found to be in violation of those requirements.
Now, this fits into, there are a lot of investigations now ongoing, government investigation, federal government, but also at the state level, number of attorneys general, correct?
Yeah, all 50 of them, actually. And this is, in large part, a state issue. The foreclosure process is governed by state laws. Many of the violations that are alleged to have occurred would have occurred in violation of state laws. And so those attorneys general investigations are really sort of where the action is right now.
And where do they stand? Do you know at this point? Or
well,
how long does this process unfold?
Yeah, we don't know how long it'll take, but we do know that some of those investigations already are unearthing some interesting things. The attorney general in Florida has released a series of depositions with employees of law firms in Florida who say that they were involved in forging signatures on foreclosure documents, filing documents that they knew were incomplete or that said things that they didn't know to be true, that they were basically involved in this robo-signing process and this, you know, fast foreclosure process.
Now, in the meantime, Bank of America, one of the key players here, we saw in Paul's piece, came out this weekend for the first time acknowledged that it had found at least a few errors.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us what they found and what they're saying.
Bank of America initially said we're going to pause foreclosures and take a look at our process, and then came back pretty quickly and said, we looked, our process works, we don't have any problems, we're going to get back to work. And the bank has now said, no, wait a second, there are some instances in which we made what it characterizes as minor or technical errors in names and documentation, but the bank has continued to insist that what has not happened is any instance in which a homeowner was wrongly foreclosed.
And some of the large banks, have now resumed processing foreclosures?
They have started to do that, right? Bank of America has launched the process of resubmitting documentation in about 100,000 cases where they're now going to proceed with foreclosures.
Now, another on the meantime here is you have some large investors pressuring the banks, this is sort of on the other side, right, to take these mortgages off their hands. Explain what's going on
well,
there.
Basically, you know, each time there's a homeowner who thinks that the bank doesn't have the right to foreclose on them, there is on the other side of that coin an unhappy investor who thinks that they own that home and would like it. And so what you've got is a growing number of investors basically saying the banks in constructing these mortgage securities, in managing these mortgage securities, were supposed to be getting us our money. And to the extent that these problems with foreclosures are threatening our investment, we want our money back.
And these are big players. Who are we talking about?
We're talking
here?
About the Federal Reserve, actually, has now joined in. The Federal Reserve Bank of New York is a participant in this effort to sue Bank of America. We're talking about BlackRock and some of the largest investors in mortgage securities in the country, and even Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, the two largest gorillas of mortgage investments.
So for them, it's not a question of who owns the mortgages, but it's whether the sales were done properly and who should be holding the bag at this point, right?
I mean, they basically know that they own the mortgages. They bought them from the banks. Their concern is that the value of those securities has declined sharply. And they're saying, basically, this wasn't just, you know, a bad bet that went wrong. This was mismanaged. This was sold to us on false pretenses. We deserve a refund.
And how big a risk is that to the banking industry as a whole?
In financial terms, that is probably the much greater risk.
Much greater.
Even if some homeowners begin to successfully avoid foreclosure, that doesn't add up to a lot of money very quickly. But a couple of cases from investors, this suit against Bank of America concerns $47 billion. There are tens of billions of dollars in other securities that could very easily be pulled into this. that's where the real money is in these investor suits against the banks.
And the government in all this continues to try to figure out how to handle it, right? I mean, on the one hand, wanting to make sure the process works right. On the other hand, and to slow it down in some sense, on the other hand, needing this housing market to work itself out.
Yeah, no, it's interesting. We're sort of exactly where we've been for 3 years now, which is that the government is walking this tightrope between, on the one hand, trying to keep the banking industry working and reviving the economy, and on the other hand, trying to hold it as accountable as possible.
I mean, you're talking to these guys every day. I mean, you see them trying to work this all out?
Well, they're trying. They haven't done it yet. But yeah, this is a struggle. They're not sure how to handle it. They're not sure in the first place what went wrong here, how badly did it go wrong, in how many cases is there a problem. People are still really trying to wrap their heads around the nature of this thing. We don't yet know what the problem is.
All right. Binyamin Appelbaum of the New York Times. Thanks very much.
My pleasure.